Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Xampp server in your industrial operating system. And then I'll also show you how to run a simple PHP code snippet in your local host. So let's begin. Now to install Xampp in your industrial operating system, you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and just simply type Xampp download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.apachefriends.org is basically our first search result. So just simply click on this download Xampp. This will automatically going to redirect you to this official website of Xampp. And if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be seeing the Xampp is available for Windows and this PHP version of 7.3.28 or 7.4.19 and 8.0.6 versions. So 8.0.6 is basically, the latest version of PHP. If you are using some older version of PHP, then you can just simply proceed with these links. But in this video, I'd like to show you how to download Xampp for using the latest version of PHP, that is this 8.0.6. So for that, you need to just simply proceed with this download 64-bit option. And this will automatically going to start downloading Xampp. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see the Xampp 8.0.6 installer has been rightly downloaded over here. And the file size is 157 MB. I'll be also putting the link in the description, so you don't need to worry about these links and all. So you'll be getting the link in the description only. Alright. And now, this is the installer. To install Xampp, just simply double click on it. And after giving administrative privileges, just simply minimize my download directory. And now, as you can clearly see, our Xampp setup wizard has been rightly opened. So just simply click on next. So these are the files that you are going to be installed. That is this Apache server, MySQL, FileZilla FTP server, Marker email server, and Tomcat. And they are also going to install this PHP along with Perl. And side by side, they are also going to install PHP MyAdmin, using which we use this MySQL, and then they are also going to install this Webalizer, and then this fake sendmail. So just simply check all this, and then just simply click on next. So this is going to be your installation folder, that is this C, Xampp. If you want to change your installation destination, then you need to just simply click on this browse button, and you can change that. I'd recommend you not to change this folder and just simply click on next. And the default language is English. If you want to change this language to let's say Dutch, then you can change that. Only these two languages are available currently. So just simply select English if you wish, and then just simply click on next. And now just again simply click on next. This will automatically going to open this official website of Bitnami. For the time being, just simply minimize it, and it's now currently ready to install. So just simply click on next for installation, and it has rightly started installing Xampp. Now let's see what this Bitnami website is actually giving us. So here is currently saying that say hello to your favorite application on Xampp. So if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be seeing that they have these various web builder called this WordPress, Joomla, Drupal, and all. So all these are very, very useful web builders. I have already made a video on how to use this WordPress in your local host. I'll be also putting the link in the description. So I recommend you to also check that video so that you can use this beautiful feature of Xampp, that is this WordPress, and how to use this WordPress for absolutely free in your local host. So do watch that video as well. You will get to know more about this website and all using that video. Now the installation is currently running. It's now currently unpacking some files. It will take some time to install, maybe a couple of minutes or even more. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing Xampp. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now as you can clearly see, our Xampp has been rightly installed and it's not kind of telling that whether we'd like to start our control panel now. So just simply check this and just simply click on finish. So this will automatically going to open your control panel. And now as you can clearly see, our Xampp control panel has been rightly opened. So you can just simply start your Apache and you can also start your MySQL. So just simply start your Apache and MySQL and then just simply minimize your Xampp and then just simply go to your C directory and then you'll be seeing this Xampp folder. So just simply double click on it and then you'll be seeing this htdocs folder. This is very important, guys. Just remember this htdocs folder. For Xampp, using this htdocs folder, we basically host our PHP file. So Xampp uses this htdocs folder, which basically acts as a server in your local host. And now, as promised, now I'd like to show you how we can run your PHP file. So for that, just simply click on a new folder and let's name this as a PHP underscore program. So go inside that folder. In here, I'd like to create a new file where we'd like to simply write a PHP code snippet. So just simply right click on it first and then just simply click on new, then text document. So in here, just simply go inside that text document and here let's write a simple PHP code snippet. So angular bracket PHP, then just simply close that tag and here just simply type hello, first decode, then hello world, and then just simply go to file, then save as, and then you need to save this file as, let's give a file name as prog, then .php. This is very important. You need to save this file as .php extension, and also you need to save as type as to all file. So you need to do these two things. First, you need to save this file as your file name then .php. And you need to save this file as type all file and then just simply click on save. So this will going to create this prog file with a .php extension. You can clearly see this PHP file. You can always delete this new document, that will not create any problem. So now that you have actually saved your simple PHP code snippet inside this prog file, so just simply go to your favorite browser, just open a new tab. And in here, just simply type local host, then enter. This will automatically going to redirect you to this Xampp's dashboard. So in here, just go again to your htdoc. So you have saved this program inside this PHP underscore program directory. So just simply right click on it, then copy. Just copy that folder name. Then go to your browser once again, then go to this URL, just simply delete this dashboard, then simply right click on it and paste PHP program, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this page called index of PHP program. So this PHP program is basically your name of your folder, and you can clearly see this prog.php file has been rightly shown over here. So if you just simply click on that, you'll be seeing this hello world has been rightly shown in our browser. So that is basically coming from your PHP program, this hello world. You can always verify that by just simply changing, if you just simply change this to hello everyone and then just again go to file, then save, and if you just reload it, you'll be seeing this hello everyone rightly shown in our browser. So in this way, you install Xampp server in your industrial operating system, and then I have rightly shown you how to run a simple PHP program in your local host. So that's basically all about this video. I have this website called geekyscript.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check our website geekyscript.com. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.